Hi there. In this section, you are going to learn about the difference and complement offsets. So let's begin. Difference offsets. Collection of all the elements left in the given set after subtraction. This simply means that elements after operation belongs to the first set. In other words, we can say that if we subtract two sets, then the resultant will be equal to the elements left after subtraction, and that belongs to the first set. The symbol to represent the difference is this symbol, which is basically same as the subtraction. In order to understand the difference of sets, what I'm going to do, I'm going to consider an example. So my example is, let's consider two sets. A is equal to 1, 2, 3, and set B is equal to 2, 3, 4, and 5. What I'm going to do, I'm going to consider the Venn diagram to explain these two sets and the difference of these two sets. So this is my universal set, this is my set A, and this is my set B. If you look closely, the element 2 and 3 is common in both the two sets. So that element will come here in the common area. So 2 and 3 will stay in the common area, which is this area. If I take a 2 and 3 out of 1, then only element is left is 1, and that will go over there. In the same way, the element left for B after taking out the common element is 4 and 5, which will go over here. So, as you can see, all the elements of set A and B are over here. If I follow the definition of difference of sets, I will write A minus B is equal to 1. Because if I take out the common element out of set A, only element left is 1. In the same way, if I subtract B minus A, I will take out all the common element, which is this area. So if I take that thing out, only element left is 4 and 5, which is over here. So we can write B minus A is equal to 4, 5. Now let's talk about a complement of a set. So complement of a set is a set of all elements of universal set except the elements of set A. In other words, we can say that if we want to find the complement of any set, we will consider all the elements of universal set except the element of set A. The symbol to represent the complement of a set A is A dash. In order to explain the complement of a set, what I'm going to do, I'm going to consider an example. So my example is, let's consider two sets and set A is ABE and universal set U is ABCDEFGH. In order to explain the complement of a set, what I'm going to do, I'm going to consider my Venn diagram. So this is my universal set U and these are the elements of universal set. So as you can see, all the elements are here, which is basically A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and they are all scattered all over place on the universal set. Now it's time for us to graph the set A, and if I do that, I will consider the elements of set A as A, B, and E, and I will draw a circle, which is A, and all the elements of set A are here, which is basically A, B, and E. So the complement of set A will be all the elements that are not the part of set A. So basically, all the elements outside of A will be the element of complement of the set A. So we can write the complement of set A as C, D, F, G, and H, and which is basically A dash is equal to C, D, F, G, H. And that's how we find the complement of set. Let's talk about the properties of complement sets. So the first column represents all the laws and the second column represents the notation. So the first law is complement laws, where A union A dash is equal to universal set and A intersection A dash is equal to phi. De Morgan law is A union B whole dash or complement is equal to complement of A intersection complement of B. And we can also say that A intersection B complement is equal to complement of A union complement of B. Law of double complementation. This simply means that A complement of whole complement is equal to A. Law of empty set. So law of empty set is basically the complement of empty set is equal to universal set. Law of universal set. This simply means that complement of universal set is phi set, because universal set has all the elements, and if we take out all the elements, you have left with empty set. Distributive law. A intersection B union C is equal to A intersection B union A intersection C.